Good afternoon, YouTube. So I wanted to show you a couple more things about this remote control, and I guess it also applies to the display right on the water heater. You get the same functionality, but one thing you can do is if you're at 120 or below, you can actually just change the hot water temperature without doing the two button push. The other thing I think you can do here is if you hold the info button, you can change between Celsius and Fahrenheit. So 3 second hold, and there's your units changed. The only time you have to do the two button hold here, yeah, there we go. Once the display flashes, then you can change up to 140. And what I want to do is run my dishwasher. So what I'm going to do first is I'll turn on the kitchen sink to get the hot water flowing. I think it's about 1.2 gallons a minute. That's the flow of the kitchen sink. Water's getting hot, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to turn on the dishwasher. Oh, there we go. So we're up to 2.6 gallons a minute there. Let's see what kind of temperature rise we're getting. So that's the incoming temperature, 71, and the outgoing is 146. So actually a little higher than the set point. So yeah, I just run the kitchen sink to pull or flush all the cold water out of the pipes, so that when the dishwasher runs, it is pulling hot water in. But let me check these numbers and we'll see what kind of natural gas consumption, because you can use this display to figure out how much gas you're using. Okay, YouTube, so I just ran those numbers here, and if we can see that on the top line, we had 71 Fahrenheit in inlet water, 146 Fahrenheit out, which represents a 75 degree temperature rise. And then we had a flow rate of 2.6 gallons a minute. If you multiply that by the weight of a gallon of water, you get 21.68 pounds of water per minute. With BTUs, that's the temperature rise times the weight in pounds, gives you 1626 BTU per minute. And then if you multiply that by 60, you get 97,600 BTU per hour. And there's roughly 1,000 BTUs in a cubic foot of natural gas. So we're basically pulling 97.6 cubic feet per hour of natural gas while the heater was running there. And this Takagi heater, I think, is rated 120,000 BTU per hour, or 120 cubic feet per hour of gas. So we're getting up pretty close to that. That's the highest I've seen. So yeah, just to wrap this up, if you just take this as your pounds of that a gallon of water weighs, so 8.34 pounds per gallon, and then this is the 60 minutes in an hour, gives you approximately 500. So all you need to do is take your temperature rise, your outlet water, inlet water, take the difference of that, take that number, and then take your gallons per minute, multiply that by 500, so 500 times 2.6 times 75, gets you your BTUs per hour, and then just divide that by 1,000 to get your cubic feet per hour, and then divide that by 100 to get down to your therms. So that's roughly 0.97 therms per hour, 97 cubic feet per hour, 97,000 BTU per hour. So everything's just powers of 10. Pretty easy factor there, just a 500 times the temperature rise times the gallons per minute. So yeah, if you have any questions about how to compute those numbers, post up in the comment section below. I'll try to type out the numbers there if you want to look at the formulas in detail. I'll put some other videos on the water heater install over on the side. And as always, Thanks for watching.